Once in a long while, a rare man and a rare moment coincide, and so it was last night. You had to be there. And fortunately, Lloyd Kramer was.
Thank you, Jim. Family, history, religious survival, the story continues, the most recent chapter, though, really beginning 30 years ago. Menachem Schneerson, his father-in-law having died, leaving him with the leadership of a very large Hasidic tradition, the Lubavitch community, where anniversaries like these are extremely important, so much so that last night's 30th, in New York at least, was the largest of its kind ever. Rumor had it he was now in the building. And so we are soldiers of our Rebbe, they chanted, waiting for his message. First impression, looking out past literally waves of believers, it is always a bit startling to see such religious fervor in what some see as our button-down secular society. Think about it.
Besides the music,
can you think?
It's very difficult, it's overwhelming.
And not just in Crown Heights. Earlier in the day, the Lubavitch community had dispatched its so-called mitzvah tanks to other parts of the city to spread the word. But again, the word finally at 9:30 last night was that Rabbi Menachem Schneerson, the 78-year-old Rebbe, or top rabbi in a lineage that began in Russia, was indeed here and about to speak. Your source is the Torah, he told them, holy scriptures, and you should live by them. For hours he spoke in Yiddish, while a communications center retransmitted the message around the world to 118 different places.
And then we find the real truth among scholars, like the
in English.
Public says.
Hebrew. And French. Also for radio station WEVD, Rabbi Jacob Hecht had the enormous task of trying to simply summarize during several five-minute intermissions.
When one thinks back and looks back into the life of this individual, to this great personality, this should give the individual the strength and fulfillment. Back to the Rebbe.
Frustrating, nearly impossible. They listened, and they listened, and they listened. At least one person in this international crowd, police estimated was between 8 and 10,000, said he was here just for the night.
Where are you from?
I'm from London.
You're also from London?
Yes.
Did you come here just for this?
Yes, I just came here. I'm leaving tomorrow again.
Presidential advisor Stuart Eisenstadt was there, right up front. Meantime, outside this complex, from a man born in Siberia.
You're going to stay here until the end?
Until the end.
Which?
Means about 3, 4 o'clock in the morning.
Actually, it turned out only until 2:15. The point is, all Lubavitchers think of this as a kind of pilgrimage, even ones who live relatively close by.
I travel here every time just to hear his words of wisdom. It means a lot to me.
Where are you from?
I'm from... Oh, East Flatbush.
For a few
but also outside, some evidence that hundreds of recent Lubavitcher emigres from Iran, many of them, are now leaving Crown Heights.
If you see, now we are about 100 boys and girls together. And if you compare this with the number that we were before, it's 10 times less than before.
But unified they all were last night. And if there's a footnote to this story, it could be found, finally, in that despite what your father tells you, you just had to be there.
Father told me.
Your father told you?
Yeah.
What did he tell you?
What the Rebbe said.
And what did the Rebbe say?
My father didn't explain me so good.
Well, Moshe, next year on Eastern Parkway, we can try it again. Rowan? Well,